Do subscribe to Ikeda channel and press bell icon to get updates about latest engineering, HSE and IIT JEE main and advanced videos.
Hello students, in this video we'll discuss about centripetal force and centrifugal force. Students, in this video we'll discuss about centripetal force and centrifugal force. So this is 1.6. We'll discuss about centripetal force and centrifugal force. As we have discussed about centripetal acceleration. When a body is moving in a circumference of the circle, along the circumference of the circle, the centripetal acceleration is towards the center. And the body having mass m multiplied by the centripetal acceleration is centripetal force. So centripetal force, I write Fc, is mass times centripetal acceleration. As we have seen, and the direction of centripetal force is same as the centripetal acceleration. The centripetal force is always towards the center. Centripetal force is always acting towards the center of circular motion. And obviously its formula you write as m acceleration is v square upon r, that will be derived last time. And m omega square r or m v omega. So these are the formula used, and omega can also be written as 2 pi over t, because theta over t, and this is also 2 pi n frequency, in terms of frequency. You can put it here, and also you'll get another variation of Fc. Now, centripetal force and centrifugal force. Now, what about centrifugal force? This is the force responsible for circular motion. If this force is not there, then the body will not move in a circular path. So this is the necessary condition for the body to move in a circle, that it requires a necessary centripetal force. Centrifugal force is the force which is equal in magnitude of that of centripetal force, but its direction is just opposite to that of centripetal force. That means centripetal force is radially inward and centrifugal force is radially outward. Now, if I talk about centrifugal force, then it will be radially outward, like so. This is centrifugal force. And this is centripetal force. So they are oppositely directed and magnitude is same. Now I'll just write the difference between the two, that is distinguish between the centripetal force and centrifugal force. Centripetal force, you write the definition, responsible for circular motion. It is responsible for circular motion. Centrifugal force is not responsible. Second point is that it is the cause of circular motion. Is the cause of circular motion, and this is the effect of circular motion. Effect of circular motion. And when we talk about the frame of reference, centrifugal force is experienced only in non-inertial frame of reference. Experienced in non-inertial frame, it is experienced only in non-inertial frame. This is centripetal force is a resultant force acting towards the center. And it is expressed in both the frames. So whatever frame you take, it is independent of that. If in that case, you can write inertial plus non-inertial. Because in the free body diagram, we draw whether you consider inertial frame or non-inertial frame, you draw all the net forces acting, and that net forces is nothing but the centripetal force. So when you write all the net forces toward the center, that itself is the centripetal force. So indirectly, you are whether you are in a non-inertial frame or inertial frame, you have to, in free body diagram, you have to draw the necessary forces responsible, and that will constitute to centripetal force. Another point you can add to this, that in terms of direction, it is radially inward, and this is radially outward. Direction is radially inward, and its direction is radially outward. Okay, so you can also write one more thing, that that this one is represented by this centripetal force is minus m omega square r vector. Here it is centrifugal force is plus m omega square r vector. This is about your centripetal force and centrifugal forces difference. Now we'll discuss some uses or where these centripetal force or centrifugal force are seen in day-to-day life. So we'll talk about, because both of them exist at the same time, we will have some examples of centrifugal force examples. We'll consider examples. The first one is, supposing that I have a table, and this is a turntable. This can rotate about the vertical axis. There is a piece of it's a coin over here. The coin is placed here. This is the coin. And if I draw the free body diagram, suppose that this is rotating, this table is rotating with angular velocity omega about this axis. Then as we keep on increasing the velocity of this table, this along with the rotation, this will also rotate. This will also rotate in this circular path. But as the speed is a certain more value, certain critical value, then this will start slipping radially outward. This will start slipping radially outward. In this direction, it will start slipping. So this is slipping, this is because of centrifugal force. And if I want to draw the free body diagram, then this is the normal reaction from the table, and the weight is downward, mg. So rotating because of frictional forces, this provides the centripetal force, and this is the centrifugal force which is in this direction. We have an example like if we have a bucket containing water. If we rotate the bucket with water in a vertical circle, then if the speed is a certain greater value, that is called the critical speed. Though if you rotate with certain critical or more than that, we will see that the water will not spill down, because there is centrifugal force. Because there is centrifugal force acting in the radial outward direction, which keeps the water, which keeps on pushing the water in the radial outward direction, and it doesn't allow the water to fall down. We have examples of when you are moving in a curve, when you are in a vehicle and it is taking a turn, then also you will feel pushed radial outward. That is centrifugal force. And one more example you can think of, in washing machine dryer, the dryer, when you put your wet clothes, then you spin it, and the dryer, the particles, water particles with the clothes, so they move out radially outward, and that's how it dries the cloth, because it spins with so high speed and the particles are experiencing the centrifugal force, which is radial outward, so they get detached from the cloth, and that cloth becomes dry. Similarly, cream separator, when that cream separator it rotates and it separates the cream, because cream experiences centrifugal force. So these are some examples. The bulging of earth, the earth is not spherical, it is something like the equator is having greater radius than the pole. The polar radius is smaller because of its rotation. About this north and south poles, that is centrifugal force in the radially outward direction, which bulges the earth, and shape changes. That is because of the centrifugal force. These are some examples of centrifugal forces. Okay, we'll discuss this much only in this video. So these are right as bulging of earth, then dryer, then we use this in car, negotiating a car. And so many examples you can have. Okay, thank you.